Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by the CEO of Caledonia Mining. It's Mark Learmonth. Mark, great to have you on the line. And a couple of bits of news out recently. We're going to start with the news from Blanket Mine. What can you tell us?
Yeah, we put out a resource upgrade a week or so ago, which shows pleasing movements in the right direction. So measured and indicated resources, which is the higher confidence level, increased from about 460,000 ounces of gold to about 1.1 million ounces. And inferred resource, which is the lowest level of resource confidence, that increased by a smaller amount, from about 500,000 to 840,000 ounces. So appreciable move in the right direction. And clearly, you know, we need resources to maintain the long-term integrity of the mine. I think I would say that over the last 2 years, as we've been focused on production and development related to the central shaft, we've not had the ability to do the sort of deep level underground exploration that we would like to do. We're now in a position where we can restart that those exploration efforts. That will take, I'd have thought, 18 months or so before we begin to see the results of that. But you know, it's a move in the right direction. I think the frustrating thing for investors in the mining space, particularly our sort of mining space, is that the good stuff, like this sort of exploration, takes years to bear the fruit of it, whereas unfortunately bad stuff happens in like a few seconds. But it's a very positive step in the right direction, so it's good news.
Understood. And I imagine you're feeling quite positive about your new solar plant as well.
Yeah, it's lovely. $14 million of solar plant sitting just across the road from the mine. We plugged it in late last year, and it's already having an appreciable effect. It provides about 27% of the electricity, average daily electricity use at the mine. It's producing slightly more than we'd expected, I think about 3 or 4% more than we'd expected. And it's contributed to a very substantial reduction in the amount of diesel that we use. That we have a full suite of standby generators, which means that if things go wrong with the grid supply, we can just fire the generators up and continue production and milling without any interruption. But that's expensive, particularly late last year, as the grid was coming under real pressure. We were using a lot of diesel, and it's substantially reduced our average diesel consumption, monthly diesel consumption last year, I think it was about 180,000 litres a month, and we've now dropped that to about 18,000 litres a month now, which is good. So it's a combination of the solar project, but also some improvement in the quality of the grid. And then I think a development that's happening right now is that we're hopefully in the short strokes of being able to import power directly from Mozambique and Zambia, which should hopefully further reduce our reliance on the Zimbabwe generating capacity and entrench a more stable electricity situation. That is good. It's very good. It's very good.
And Mark, I believe you've been in Southern Africa very recently at the Indaba conference. What did you make of it this year?
Yeah, we went down to Cape Town last week. We actually do the one-to-one conference, which runs in parallel with Indaba. And so we had a team there. They were full on for a couple of days with meetings from sort of 9 till 5 in the evening. The meetings went very well. And whilst they were busy doing that, me and a colleague, we saw some of the South African institutions whom we've not really spoken to in the past. And we came away with a very warm feeling as to the increased interest from investors in Zimbabwe, but also becoming much more confident about the availability of debt, particularly in-country debt, to support growth initiatives such as the Bilboes and the Matapa project. So it was a very good couple of days.
Mark Learmonth, CEO of Caledonia Mining, thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Thank you.